You made it. Happy to lend a hand to fight the Blaze. I think I speak for all of the Captain's Council when I say we're beyond grateful to have a group of folks like you on our side. We can ship out once the rest of Dragon's Watch gets here. It'll just be me. Oh, one person. Against a god of war. I'm sure it'll be fine.
Taimi and I faced Balthazar before, but he slipped through our fingers. It won't happen again.
Taimi, she the short one? I hear she has quite the superiority complex. Funny to have a teeny tiny body with such a massive ego, huh? What is it? Why do you have that look on your face?
I'm sure the commander's silently trying to warn you that the little narcissist might be listening.
It's technology, a remote communicator.
Yep, I'm always with the commander. Although, the Crystal Desert is farther away than we've ever tested this thing. I might not be able to stay in constant contact with you.
What a disappointment.
Look at that. You broke Scruffy's sarcasm meters. Anyway, I'll get to work on solving that problem so we'll never be apart again. Bye!
That's
pretty typical.
Well, a battalion of my best is ready to go. Talk to First Mate Fidus and he'll get you situated. I'm lending you my personal airship to get to M-Noon. Keep it in one piece. Heard you don't have the best track record with them.
No promises.
I'd be smarter to get it insured. Best of luck, Commander. It's a powder keg over there, and that maniac has already lit the fuse.
Aye, Captain.
Now let's talk shipping details.
Heading for the desert, Commander? Swordmaster Farron, Lord of Beetleton, is ready. Let Chaos Bringers and Quaggan Kickers alike beware.
Thanks, but I need you here. Someone tough and shrewd has to guard the supplies until they're loaded.
Good thinking. This is Lion's Arch. These donations could go missing in transit before they ever leave the docks.
Not with you on the case. Thanks. I'll feel a lot better with someone I can count on to keep an eye on things.
Happy to contribute. Bon voyage, old chum.
Farron, my friend, never call someone who's about to cross the ocean chum.
Whoops! I should know better. Especially after that fiasco with Marula at the apiary. I kept calling her honey. She still blames me for all those bee stings. Who knew the buzzy little beggars had such good hearing?
Live well.
Sheriff, just wanted to say how glad I am Keel brought you in. This job requires skill and know-how like yours.
I know even more than Keel thinks. She and Magnus aren't working with the full council. That's why they called me in. Either they're sick of debating, or it's a power grab. Or they just plain don't trust the council to do the right thing. That's why I love this town. Even our leaders live by the rule, it's easier to get forgiveness than permission.
You may be right, but even if they are being tricky, the desert region needs help, and Balthazar has to be stopped.
Oh, I support the cause, but I'm not taking the heat when the council finds out. Good hunting, Commander.
Commander, on behalf of the Captain's Council, thanks for pitching in to support our relief efforts.
Though you and Keel are the only counselors I see, this operation is a bit unusual for Lion's Arch, isn't it?
Don't worry. Keel and I will handle the full council. Now get out there and kick Balthazar's divine teeth in.
Consider it done. The next time we speak, we'll have one less mad god to contend with. Magister Stonehealer, thank you for the Priory's contribution. I feel I should warn you.
That you can't guarantee the safety of my scholars and explorers. Don't worry, our people can handle themselves. Just remember to share any important discoveries you make. Alona's been isolated for a long time. There must be a treasure trove of data about the Forgotten, Ascension, and the Dragons just waiting to be discovered. I'm also eager to see how their societies have diverged from ours. And if dwarven culture had any lasting impacts.
I'll support your people as best I can. But I've got a mission of my own. Good luck, Ogden. Until we meet again.